today. Look how much wind there is. And it was just thunderstorming just now. So I'm just going to chill here today at the radio. I'm actually going to get interviewed at around 8:30.
This time of year, is it still snowy up there?
There's some bit of weather through here. What I was asking was just about this type of weather.
But
I'm assuming it's probably the same right now.
Are you in school or?
No, I graduated and I'm like 30.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's complicated.
Yeah. It's hard to tell if it's.
Oh, yeah. Around here. In the United States, we got a lot of these cars.
We
get a lot of cash.
Yeah, I have been. And then people always look at the ID because it's a behavior. So, I guess they don't get that.
Have you lived in Canada all your life?
I lived there about 1 year. I came from China when I was 10.
Oh, okay.
And then I worked abroad for 4 or 5 years.
Okay.
And then went back to Canada. So you have a morning show every
10 seconds.
Welcome to Clary Connection. I'm Ron Wilshire, and it's a very windy day out there today. We have trash cans and recycling containers blowing all over the streets, so be careful. And on this windy day, on Wednesday, this will be rebroadcast on Sunday morning. I guess the logical question, who can blow in the town? We have a young man, Jack Chai, from Canada, who is bicycling throughout America, and we thought we'd talk with him a little bit. He was on our FM sister station earlier. Welcome, Jack.
Thanks for having me, Ron.
So, you're from Canada. You said you were born in China.
Yep.
And have been in Canada for about 20 years.
That's right, yeah.
Okay. And what prompted you to think about taking this epic? What kind of job do you have that allows you to do that?
Well, I worked a couple of years abroad. The most recent job I had was in Australia. I was an account manager for a tech company. And so I saved a bit of money, and so now we can kind of travel like this. But of course, there's always resources that you can find online. For example, the reason why I'm here at the station is because I'm using this website called Warm Showers, which is specifically for bike tours. So if you're traveling long distance across the country, what you can do is go on this website and you can look for hosts along the way. And most of these hosts, they're like tourists themselves. So they'll open up their homes for you and you get a place to stay and shower and then before you head out to your next destination. So actually, Bill, who's the owner of the station, he accepted me and so that's why I'm here.
Oh, great. Yeah, Bill Hurston, he's a pretty outdoorsy type guy.
For sure, yeah.
Has some bikes and that. So, where are you going when you came down from Canada?
Yeah, so I came from Toronto. And the destination right now is Miami. But if I have extra time, because I only have about 6 months of my U.S. visa, but if I have extra time, maybe I'll go west after Miami, so to California, or you can down south to South America.
Well, that's interesting. I hadn't thought of that, but you to enter the United States, you have to get a visa from Canada or
from the border. Yeah, right. Yeah, it's just a visa upon entering. I just crossed the border at Niagara and just going through, they give you a 6 month visa that you can stay in the country, and then any longer than that, they'll kick you out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Anymore, yeah.
Yeah, you wouldn't be welcome again in the future.
Well, what? Tell us about what kind of bike you're riding and for what kind of equipment you have to pack with you.
I think it all depends on the season. So right now, because I started kind of in the early spring, late winter-ish time, what I have is just a basic road bike. I got it. It's the cheapest one from Amazon, and then I outfitted with front racks and rear racks, and I carry 4 panty bags. So that keeps me like that. That includes everything I need on the road, like repair kits, my sleeping tent, sleeping bag in case I don't buy any clothes, and clothes, and some extra provisions for like food and stuff like that.
Have you ever made this long of a trip before?
Yeah. Like this is not my first trip, but this will be the longest one. I've done a similar trip when I was living in France. I rode from Monaco to Barcelona, and that was in the summertime. Did another trip, I biked all across Korea when I was living there, and then I did one from Toronto to Montreal. So those are the three that I've done so far.
So you obviously like doing this.
Yeah, that's awesome. I don't know, like most people, like when I tell them, they're like, oh, it's like, it's crazy you're doing this, it's gonna take forever. But for me, it's enjoyable. Like I don't mind at all. You get to go at your own pace, you get to meet awesome people, and it's a cool experience. I like it.
What do you do on a day like today? You know, this is Wednesday. Some people are listening to it Sunday, but on a windy, rainy day. How do you treat that if you're on the bike?
Right. Well, generally, I try not to ride in the rain. So, and I'm not in a big hurry. So, if I'm already on the road, I'll just stop by and wait for the rain to stop. But if I'm not on the road like I am today, I'll just chill somewhere. Today, I'm just chilling at the station, waiting for the rain to pass, and then tomorrow I'll head out.
So what do you learn on these trips? You do, not just the United States, but I'm sure you meet a lot of interesting people.
Yeah, for sure. I think the main thing is just culture. I've heard about the United States, obviously, a lot from the news and stuff. But until you're actually there and you meet the people, you talk to them, you don't really know what it's like in Clarion, Pennsylvania. Before this, I never even knew where that was. So culture is a big thing. Also, I learned about the kindness of strangers. Like most of this trip is funded by the kindness of strangers.
Oh, that's great. Well, today in the news, obviously China's a lot in the news with the trade embargo.
Sure.
And obviously we're coming talks with North Korea.
Yeah.
And you've had both of those places.
Yeah.
Maybe not North Korea.
Not in North Korea. Although I could have, like there's a demilitarized zone you can visit when you're in South Korea. But it's crazy. I mean, like there's a lot of things going on in the world, and I think it's probably better if you just go there and see it yourself as opposed to just take it on face value from the news.
Well, and you have the opportunity to explain things to people that
right.
don't get that option.
Exactly.
In there, but
yeah.
Because of probably a lot of people. Back of their minds, well, I'd like to do that,
right?
You know, for various reasons.
Yeah, I think I'm quite fortunate to live in Canada and then to do where I've lived before. But like a trip like this, anybody can really do it. It's not that expensive. All you really need is a bike and some panties, and you can find like the most expensive thing about the trip will be like your food and your accommodation. Accommodation, of course, you can find online, like house sharing or warm showers, or you can just camp somewhere. So the most important thing is just like, well, I think most people will have time to do it.
Well, with these online sites for possible housing, I imagine that's all verified before, so you're probably entering a pretty safe place.
Right. It's a lot of it is just like common sense. But the website does have like verification purposes. So whenever you stay with somebody, they can leave you a review and then you can leave them a review. So So you, before you go to somebody's home, you can check out the reviews to make sure everything's okay. But I tend to be pretty trusting when I've stayed at people with no reviews, and it's been great too, because everybody starts somewhere. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I assume you work in technology somehow.
Yeah.
And I was thinking about another advantage of this thing is you're getting away from that
right.
daily grind of technology.
Yeah, exactly.
And so it's probably a chance to relax too.
Yeah. But like, I'm never fully away from technology because when I'm on my bike, I have my headphones on, I have Google Maps on, telling me where to go.
And I see you have a camera.
I film like my adventures just for my own like memories to remember them by, and for family and friends, I put them on YouTube. But it's interesting. Like I think I'll look back on this like 5, 10 years and be like, oh yeah, I remember that one time at the radio station I got interviewed by Ron. That's pretty cool.
Well, yeah. What other things have you been able to do since you've been here with Bill?
So I only arrived yesterday. But yesterday I was lucky because I rode in when they had the karaoke contest.
Okay.
Right. So they have the and we went. We were at I think it was called Basil's and
Sweet Basil's.
That's it. And it was great. Lots of talented singers came out. I sang poorly.
Oh really?
Yeah.
What song did you sing?
Oh, I sang "Grenade" by Bruno Mars, but I butchered it. It was terrible.
Well, karaoke. Yeah, you actually sing. You don't just mouth.
Right. Okay. You sing, and but there was some really talented singer there.
Mm-hmm.
In the first place and second place, they get to go on to the next competition. And I believe there's a $300 prize at the end of the contest.
So they had a lot of people getting on to sing.
Yeah, for sure. It's definitely. Yeah, of course, it's part of this competition, but after it, anybody can just join it.
Right. I noticed on when I was coming into the station, there's a nice poster up for it.
There's
a number of karaoke sessions.
Yeah, definitely. I think the next one's happening like 2 weeks or something. Just check the Facebook website.
Plan to do any other karaoke's on your trip?
I love karaoke. I think this will probably be the only time I'm staying on a radio station, but if I find another one, I'm always down for it.
Have you ever visited the South of the United States?
No, never. That's like what's exciting to me. Like just
there's a lot of just different changes.
Okay. What time?
Well, I don't know. I mean, we've traveled there somewhat, but some people say it's a lot more conservative.
Okay, yeah.
And it's just a different flavor.
Right on. I'll have to see for myself.
Yeah. So, well, that's great. And then you make it to Miami.
Mm-hmm.
You don't ride back up, do you?
Well, like the plan is, it's not recent, so I pretty much just plan 1 or 2 days ahead of time.
Right.
But I think I'm going to get there and have some extra time. I'll ride to California. And my ultimate plan is to sell the bike wherever I am and then buy a van, like a white sprinter van, like Mercedes or something, like a really old one, and then just strip out the insides and then build a little tiny home inside. So that way I can travel some more.
Okay. Well, how long do you think it'll take to get to Miami?
Probably 3 months, I would say.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then you might spend the other 3 months to
to
live in your van down by the river.
Something like that. Yeah. If that's a dream.
Well, yeah, and that you could take home with you too if you wanted to.
Yeah, exactly. That's the beauty of it. I think it's like you have your mobile home and you can travel anywhere you want. If you like a place, you stay for longer. If you don't, go to the next place. Like, well, my bike is nice, but I can only travel so many miles a day.
Right.
Yeah.
If you want to talk about it, what are some of the differences between Canada and the United States that you've observed, if there are any?
So far, like, to tell you the truth, like, when I crossed the border, I didn't really notice that much of a difference. It's pretty similar. The one difference I would say is you guys have a lot of flags. So like almost like every property I pass by, there's a prominent American flag, which is awesome. But in Canada, you wouldn't see that that often, I would say. You'd probably see a flag like every 50, 100 houses, or something like that. But other than that, not many things I can think of. Of course, I still have to go further south, because I imagine the northern states are pretty similar to Canada.
You know, one of the issues a lot of people talk about generally is the idea of healthcare.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
And I was just curious, how do you have that worked out for you?
Oh, so I don't have healthcare at all in the States.
Right.
I have Canadian insurance. But my whole thing is like I'm a pretty young guy. I don't think I'm going to get sick. And if something terrible were to happen, Canada is just flying away. So I'll fly back and get freaking healthcare in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because that might be the big difference.
Yeah, I think so. I didn't even think of that. That's right, yeah.
Well, that shows that you're young.
Yeah, I got to think about these things.
An old person's question, I guess. What do you think you're just going to absorb culture here and talk to people?
Right on, yeah. That's pretty much it. I love going to like different homes and houses, just checking out how people live. And people are very welcoming and just nice. I was telling Jesse, in the house, about this crazy story. Like, people are just so kind. Like, I went from Warren, passed through Sheffield 2 days ago. And on that day, my stop was Marionville, which was another like 20 miles from Sheffield. I rode past this gentleman. He was doing some workout for London. His name is James. I rode past him, and then he came out with his pickup truck. And he just stopped, and he's like, "Hey, I don't know where you're going, but if you need a place to stay, stay at my place here in Sheffield's." I was like, "Yeah, great, why not?" So I stayed at his place, he took me fishing, that was pretty fun. And then the next day, it was just boring, kind of like today. And I was going to come to Clarion to stay with Bill. And he was like, "No, I'll just drive you." So he actually drove me from Sheffield to Clarion, which is like an hour away, and he has to drive an hour back. And it was just the kindest thing. Like, I meet people like that all the time on the road, and it's just been great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's great. So, have you fished before?
Yeah, mm-hmm. I love fishing. I've fished since I was a little kid.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so we didn't catch anything, but it was just fun being out there in nature.
Where'd you go to school at?
I went to University of Toronto. In Toronto, did 4 years there, and then after that, I went abroad to teach English for a couple of years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I know some people around here go to Canada for college sometimes, I read.
Right, that's right, yeah. We don't have that many, I guess you guys call it colleges, but we call them universities. We don't have that many university or colleges in Canada. I think education is good. The only thing to complain about is the high tuition.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because like in Europe, it's like most of the countries free tuition, so that was a big difference when I went there.
Well, so they can charge tuition in Canada.
Yeah. The tuition is about the same as here, I would say. Maybe a little bit cheaper. How much is tuition here?
It really depends on what school you go to.
Right.
Like a place like Clarion University, which is one of 14
right.
In Pennsylvania. Oh, it's been so long since I've been checking. It's the tuition itself is probably $7,000 or $8,000 a year.
Okay, well, yeah, okay, it'll be expensive. Like, you guys have it more expensive here.
Yeah, now, part of what happens in the United States is some people qualify for financial aid.
Right.
And then they get assistance there. But like, you know, a private school is probably $40,000 a year.
Oh, wow. That
so,
is expensive.
So I think somebody might be subsidizing Canada. But,
right.
But a lot of people, and then private schools, they get the scholarships available.
Yeah.
And so it's, you know, you always have to look for real sticker prices.
Right. Yeah, my tuition was about $5,000 a year, Canadian.
Yeah.
So converted to American for like 4 hours.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, then you end up, too, is there's always like housing costs.
Right.
And activity fees.
Yeah, so you got all added all up.
Yeah. Yeah. So, but, so I managed somehow or other.
Yeah.
Committing subsidized.
Right. Some.
Right. So, and really a lot of the states now are emphasizing the need for, help train jobs, you know, hands-on skills.
Yeah, like technical colleges.
Yeah, yeah, and even things like construction,
okay,
and
yeah,
everything like that. So they're emphasizing that now too. Mm-hmm. So it's quite a smorgasbord of opportunities you can get.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea. And like one thing I would like, I love my university education, but I just wish there were more hands-on stuff, like something that can help you transition into like the real world.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it's great that you guys are taking that route.
What was it? Oh, you taught English.
No. I graduated and then I taught English in Korea for a year, which a lot of people do because it's a great way to save up money. The cost of living there is really cheap, everything's cheap, and also they provide you with accommodation and airfare. So I taught there for a year, saved a little bit of money, traveled a bit, and when I came back to Canada, I was like, oh, this is great, I'll just keep on doing this. So I went to Quebec, which is the French-speaking side of Canada, teach English some more, and then I went to France to teach English. And then when I came back to Toronto, I found a job, and then it was opening in Australia. So I packed up my bags and I moved to Australia.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Any other countries you want to visit?
Yeah, like, I've never been to any countries in South America, so, like, Panama, Honduras, like, all these countries in South America, I would love to go there.
You have to talk to Bill. I think one or two of his kids were exchange students.
Yeah, yeah. I was talking to Kristen. I think she taught in Baja in Mexico, and so I'm learning Spanish right now, so.
I think she was Rotary Exchange student.
Oh, okay.
Bill and I are both in Rotary. I know my daughter spent a year in Finland.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Is she still there?
No, she's in New Orleans.
Oh, okay.
So she did that, and then she came back for her college degree and spent, I think, a semester in Amsterdam.
Nice.
And,
yeah.
So she really likes going to other places. And
yeah.
She telecommutes her job now.
Okay.
With UPMC of Pittsburgh.
Oh, wow. That's awesome.
So yeah, I think a lot of young people like trying to do that for their home.
Yeah, yeah. Like, I think traveling is like one of the big things for millennials. Like, it's more about having experience versus the learning things. Like, most of the stuff I have is just on my bike.
Yeah. I'd ask this to anybody, do you sometimes regret the classification millennial? It's sometimes used.
yeah, like I mean, I am a millennial, but I feel like some of the millennials are quite entitled. They complain a lot about things, about not getting their way. And I guess the trend now is to be like a victim. Like, you can't say anything. Everything is offensive to everybody. So I don't really subscribe to that, but my mantra is, as long as you do good unto others as with yourself, that's fine with me. As long as you don't hurt anybody, that's fine with me.
Mm-hmm. So, that's sort of the old rule.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Well, and you couldn't be doing what you're doing and be someone that's going to complain.
Right, exactly. Well, there's
or
no,
you're
no
sleeping or
yeah,
you're getting there.
Yeah, no, there's nobody to complain to, even if you wanted to.
So in itself, that's probably a good education.
Yeah, yeah.
So what does your family think about your trips?
My family don't really care for it, I would say. They try to discourage me from doing it, but I mean, it's my life. I just do whatever I want.
Sure. Well, there may be, again, land stereotypes about how terrible it might end up being when you're on the road.
Yeah.
Just kind of worry about you.
Yeah, exactly. I think that's the main thing. But then I do, like, film like, kind of daily videos so they can see where I am and see what I'll do. So that's kind of, like, helps with that.
You ever plan to do a book or a video on your travels?
Yeah, like a video for sure. Book probably not, because like it, mainly just for me. There's a lot of people doing this type of thing, so
sure.
It's not like I'm unique somehow. But whatever I do, it's just mainly for me. If somebody wants to watch it, sure, great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Does it ever get lonely on the road?
Not really. But I mean, like I've only been on the road for like 2 weeks. But like almost every day or every other day, I meet someone new, so it's always an opportunity to get more people.
Mm-hmm. Any, well, I know you've only been 2 weeks.
Yeah.
You've already met some interesting people that I took you in and were able to
ride.
Yeah.
Yeah.
From your other trips, is there anyone that stands out in your mind that you met that was kind of unique?
Oh, there were so many. When I was in, when I was in France, I slept in a castle once.
Wow.
Yeah, and it was, so I arrived at this this couch surfer in Marseille, and I arrived and he said, hey, there's a party going on tonight, you want to come? I was like, sure, why not? And so he took me to the party, and it was in this huge castle, and we're just partying there. And I was asking the owner, I was like, why do you live in a castle? Apparently in France, nobody wants to live in a castle because castles are really expensive to upkeep. And the reason why he was living in a castle was because he was offered that accommodation by the international school that was next to it. So he has a castle all to himself and just partying there. And so that was pretty cool. You get into all sorts of different adventures.
Well, that, you know, even places in the United States, at one time, they built large houses,
right?
And a lot of people they've come down some because people can't afford to
keep it up.
Like, you know, some of the oil industry kind of started around the oil stadium,
right?
And they built these elaborate houses.
Yeah.
But you find a lot of times people then, you know, if they can't afford to, they can convert them to put little apartments in it,
right?
So it may have been a castle one time. But
yeah.
So that's something similar all over the world.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
Well, Europe stresses smaller things in the United States, like housing and that type of thing.
Yeah. Yeah, like all the houses there are way smaller, and the cars as well, because the streets are narrower.
Mm-hmm.
But it really goes to showing that you really don't need much space. I can't speak for the U.S., but in Canada, at least, we have so much land that people build these gigantic houses on them. And there's like one or two people living in them max. Like, I think it's just a waste of resources for giving that to people that really need it.
Right. Well, in the United States, there are some developments that you call them.
Right, exactly. They're cookie cutter.
Yeah, and they're a large, nice house, but it's crammed in a little lot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've seen those before, yeah. But it's nice out here, you guys have lots of land, and have like mm-hmm. front yard, backyard, everything going. I like it here.
Now, when you plan your trip, you plan smaller roads to ride on?
Yeah, so I generally try to ride bike trails if there are. If not, I'll go on like the shoulders of small roads. But basically, I just put on Google Maps. Google Maps has this bike option, and most of the time it's been pretty good. Yeah.
Oh, that's great. I didn't know they had that part on there, so.
Yeah.
Around Clarion County and Wilson, there are some nice bike trails.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've heard about that. I think I'm probably going to be taking those down.
So, and some, depends on the community. Some people really volunteer and they almost paved the trails.
Okay.
Yeah. And it's pretty. It's pretty nice.
Yeah.
I rent a new bathroom for my brothers.
Okay. I'll have to look into that. Yeah.
Sure. So, any major events planned for the rest of your trip? Other than buying a van and making it into a home?
Our major events? Not really. Just like, I think every event is kind of major and minor in some way.
Any like, sites or tourist attractions along the way?
Oh, yeah. So, I'm pretty excited to head over to Washington, the nation's capital. I'm a big history buff. I love learning about history, so I think there'll be a lot of great sites to see there. So that'll be like my next big stop for me there. Just check out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, that'd be good. But, yeah. Do they have these websites for bikers in like Washington? Because it's so.
Oh yeah, actually, it's even easier to find a host in big cities because there's just the population density, there's more people there.
Mm-hmm.
So I would probably have no trouble finding a host there. But sometimes you just want to be alone for a while. So sometimes when I get in a big city, I like to stay for a long time. I just get a hotel or like a hostel. Yeah. Just because like, I don't want to overstay my welcome. Like stay in somebody's house for like a week or something.
Yeah, the hostel's a pretty good option too. I mean, that's been in Europe for a while.
So. Yeah, for sure.
It's aimed at students or young people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I find here in the States and Canada, the hostels are almost expensive as the hotels. So I think hotel provides more comfort for relatively like the same price. So.
Well, and you have that.
Yeah, the big bike.
Well, but you can also be by yourself.
Right,
you
exactly.
You can go out from there. But,
exactly, yeah.
And like you say, in Washington, there's so much to see.
Yeah.
The great subways as well, too.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
So, well, Jack, I appreciate you stopping by today. I mean, we'll probably have to get on the road.
Well, awesome. Thank you for having me.
Okay.
It's my first time on the radio. Hopefully, I do well.
Okay, well, yeah, we're state of the art here, and so.
Yeah.
And, you check out some other radio stations along the way.
I will try it.
Okay. Jack, thanks for joining us at Clarion Connection, and we'll talk to you next week.
Thank you.
There you are,
thank
man.
You so
great.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thanks again for coming in, man.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Is it right here?
Yeah, it is.
South Front, Park,
South Front. You want to see it?
Yeah, I was going to get a picture. I can put it on.
Yeah.